was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. This is how the birth of Jesus came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with a child. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man, did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him. And in those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem. He went there to register with Mary. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And Joseph gave him the name Jesus. And there were shepherds lying, living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord." The shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was laying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. And so, many people started to long for the Messiah, who will restore the kingdom of God on earth. But before the Messiah's arrival, first, somebody else became very famous. The word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the desert. He went into all the country around the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. So the people were waiting expectantly and were all wondering in their hearts if John might possibly be the Christ. But John answered them all, "I baptize you with water, but one more powerful than I will come, the thongs of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire." And with many other words, John preached the gospel news to them. Then a large crowd of people. The next day, John saw Jesus coming towards him and said, "Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is the one I meant when I said, 'A man who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but the reason I came baptizing with water was that he might be revealed to Israel." As Jesus was coming out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." Then John gave his testimony, "I would not have known him except that the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'The man who, on whom you see the Spirit come down and remain is he who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' I, John, have seen and I testify that this is the Son of God." Then a large crowd from Galilee followed Jesus. Jesus went and lived in Capernaum, which is by the lake. From that time on, Jesus began to preach, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." Yeah, Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom and healing every disease and sickness among the people. News about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain, the demon-possessed, those having seizures, and the paralyzed, and he healed them. One day as Jesus was standing by the lake of Gennesaret, with the people crowding round him and listening to the word of God, he saw at the water's edge two boats, left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little from shore. Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we have worked hard all night long and haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets." And when they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets began to break. So they signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so full that they began to sink. When Peter, Simon, saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord. I'm a sinful man." For he and his companions were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken, and so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, Simon's partners. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Don't be afraid. From now on you will catch men." So they pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and followed him. Another time, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side while he dismissed the crowd. And after he dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, Jesus was there alone. But the boat was already a considerable distance from land. Now the wind became stronger and stronger, and louder and louder. He could hardly stand the noise of the wind. Waves became greater and bigger and bigger. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost! It's a ghost!" they said and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid." "Lord, if it's you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. And Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and, beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me!" Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when he climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." So Jesus was preaching and healing for 3 years. Many people got healed, and numerous came to faith. Unbelievable, and very, very sad. Hard to believe, but there were other people as well. Men, mainly Pharisees, who were jealous of Jesus and who wanted to kill him. Jesus knew he will die very soon, and announced it to his disciples many times, but they didn't get it. Finally, Jesus and his disciples went to a place called Gethsemane. And Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him, and he began to be deeply distressed and troubled. "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death," he said to them. "Stay here and keep watch." Going a little further, he fell to the ground and prayed that, if possible, the hour might pass from him. "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me. Yet not what I will, but what you will." Then an angel appeared and comforted him. He returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon," he said to Peter, "are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? watch and pray, so that you not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak. One more, he went away and prayed the same thing. When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. They did not know what they to say to him. Embarrassing. Return me. The third time he said to them, are you still sleeping and resting? Enough. The hour has come. Look, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise. Let us go. Here comes my betrayer. Just as he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, appeared. With him was a crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard. Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, Rabbi, and kissed him. The man seized Jesus and arrested him. They took Jesus to the high priest and all the chief priests, elders and teachers of the law. They came together and they condemned him as worthy of death. Some of them began to spit at him. They blindfolded him, struck him with their fists, and said, prophesy. And the guards took him and beat him. Then they took Jesus, brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull, and they crucified him. The written notice of the charge against him read, the King of the Jews. They crucified two robbers with him. One on his right, and one on his left. At 12 o'clock, darkness came over the whole land. And until 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? This happened because at this very moment, Jesus has taken all our sins unto himself. Then, with a loud cry, Jesus died. The curtain of the temples was torn in two from top to bottom. And when the centurion who stood there in front of Jesus heard his cry, and so how he died, he said, surely, this man was the Son of God. As evening approached, Joseph of Arimathea, a prominent member of the council, who was himself waiting for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for Jesus' body. So Joseph bought some linen cloth, took the body, wrapped it in the linen, and placed it in a tomb cut out of the rock. Then they rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. They asked each other, who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe on the right side. And they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You're looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He's not here. See the place where they laid him." So trembled and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They went and told those who had been with him and who were mourning and weeping. Later, Jesus appeared to the 11 as they were eating. He said to them, "Go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned." And after the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven and he sat at the right hand of God. Since then, millions of people had experienced the same as the disciples and women 2,000 years ago, namely that Jesus is truly resurrected from death, and everyone who believes in him shall not perish, but is forgiven, because Jesus is alive, and heaven's gates are open wide for everybody, for you and for me, for sure. Jesus is alive, and I'm forgiven.
He's alive, I'm forgiven. Heaven's gates are open.